Hey guys, it's Bailey and welcome back to the channel. It is time once again for some monthly favorites. So in this video, I'm going to be sharing all of my July beauty favorites. Let's hop into it. First things first, let's talk nails. A lot of you guys have had questions about the polish that I've been wearing in my most recent videos, and I have been applying and reapplying this one from Julie G. It is her, it's called Universe, and it just seems like it's this interesting duochrome. It's very similar to something Chanel has. I think somebody else has another similar shade, but it is this antique gold at first look, and then you, especially in the bottle, you kind of tilt it and there are shades of green and blue. It's just a really faceted nail polish that looks summery on the nail, so I've really been wearing that. And then one problem, part of the reason that I've been steering clear of like metallic nail polishes, despite the fact that I absolutely love them in the summer, is that I have really ridged nails. And so I went ahead and just got a ridge filler. This one's from Poparazzi. I think it's a CVS exclusive. This might be one of those CVS brands, but it's a ridge filling base coat called Fill and Smooth. I guess it is a shade called Fill and Smooth. But these two together have been an absolute love, and then I put either quick dry drops from Essence over top or Sèche Vite, just whatever is around. Both, I love both. Both work great and both work pretty instantly. So that's what I'll wear, but these are the two best friends I have been loving for my nails, for those of you that have been asking. Next up is foundation, and I have two because one I go to when I am less tan with self-tanner that I will mention in this video because it's another favorite. That is the Born This Way foundation. It's a little lighter than my other favorite, which is the LC Micro Silk foundation, both of which I reviewed in July, I believe, so I will link to those in the little, if you click the eye over here, or if you click the link in the info bar, but you can check out and hear my thoughts on both of these. Obviously, they're pretty glowing reviews. I love them both. They're in my favorites video. I think they perform really similarly, but I do tend to prefer the LC because the texture, it's a little bit thicker, which doesn't necessarily mean it will cake up more easily than the Born This Way. Both give a very flawless and yet second skin looking type of natural finish, but I just find that the consistency of the LC is a little bit easier to work with, and it blends more easily into the skin so that you don't end up with some brush stroke or a lot of brush strokes like I kind of can with the Born This Way foundation. It's a very minor difference, but if push came to shove and I had to choose, would absolutely choose the LC. But because you can only order the LC online, I wasn't able to pick a shade that was just right for me, and the shade range is limited to begin with. So I did end up getting one that was a little bit too dark for my skin tone. So as a result, I do tend to need to fake tan in order to get this to match. So I haven't been wearing it as much because I've been lazy. Frankly, I've been too lazy to tan, and so haven't gotten to wear this as much as I have wanted to, but it is an absolute favorite. On to the self-tanner that I've been loving. This is Naked Skin Self-Tan, and it's in the shade Dark. It says Tinted Tan Liquid Dark. They sent a few of these to me, all of them in the shade Dark though, so this is the only one that I had to try, and I was really reaching for anything I had in my collection to get me to a shade that matched this. So really, I discovered this out of necessity, just pulling from everything I had on hand. They sent this to me, ended up giving it a try, and absolutely loving it because it's a spray, so it's very thin, it's not a lotion. Like I had previously really liked to apply because it just makes it really easy. You can ensure you got everything, it multitasks, it moisturizes, all that kind of stuff. This, you don't have to moisturize beforehand. I do exfoliate just to make sure I'm not left with any patchiness on my elbows and knees and things like that, but I don't moisturize beforehand. It's a very thin texture and consistency, so it doesn't take very long to rub in at all. And then once it's dried, which takes no more than like 1 or 2 minutes, I can put clothes on, I can put jewelry on, I can like go on with the rest of my day and not have to worry about getting it on furniture or clothing or people or whatever you have to worry about getting yourself tan on. So that is really nice. It also comes, this I am less a fan of, but I'm not sure if it comes with it when you purchase, because like I said, they sent this to me, but I did get this with the tanner itself, and it's the world's most petite tanning glove. Obviously, it's gotten a lot of love, but it doesn't fit over my whole hand or even all four fingers like a typical mitt does, so I do find that I get a little bit of tan on my palm. Obviously, I just tanned yesterday, so it really doesn't stick to your hands when you get it there, but it can make for a little bit of a mess, and maybe the reason I haven't it hasn't stained my hands is because I'm really, really good about washing my hands multiple times during application as I'm like migrating to different parts of my body to make sure it doesn't stain my hands. But that's one of the downsides, is that if you are used to or prefer having a large glove, you don't get that with this. It's just this little finger thing that, you know, it's not my favorite part of it, but absolutely love this. One word of warning though, is that when it first comes out, I was a little worried that dark, typically I'm fair to light toned, and so dark is, I would always go for medium before going for dark first. So I got this thinking I'm gonna look like an Oompa Loompa, and my fears were nearly confirmed when I sprayed it on myself for the first time and it was orange. It's not like a lot of tans that have like olive, or they almost look like they have green undertones because they end up being more olive. This definitely looks a little bit more orange when I sprayed it on, and so I was kind of nervous that it was gonna be a tan disaster, but I'm really happy to say that it does deliver a very dark tan. This is probably the darkest self-tanner I've ever used, but it doesn't look unnatural, it doesn't look super orange, and it's pretty long lasting. If I moisturize every day, I would say it lasts a week to a week and a half, which is pretty good for me. So overall, rave reviews about this. Next up is mascara. This was a favorite last month. It is the CoverGirl Supersizer Mascara, but at any given time, I have 1 to 3 mascaras that I'm testing and like rotating in between to use and compare each other against them. And so I have been using a few at the time that this was in my favorites last month, and at the time that I was reviewing this. And this month, for some reason, this is just what I have been reaching for. It has the perfect combination of volume and length and curl. It helps hold shape really well, and it doesn't come off. This is not the waterproof formula, because the regular formula stays on without streaking, smudging, flaking, anything like that. And so if I can avoid it, I always try to avoid the waterproof formula, because they can tend to be a little bit more harsh on lashes when I go to remove at the end of the day. So love this formula, not even waterproof. Highly recommend it to anyone who's wanting a good drugstore mascara. And if you've just seen this because it is relatively new to the shelves, you've been curious about it, give it a go. I really, really like it. I love what it's been doing to my lashes, and I'm really nervous for the day that it runs out, because, well, I mean, it's affordable, so I'll go get another one, more than likely. But I've been blowing through it pretty fast, so I think its days are numbered. Next up is a brush, and this is actually an update to an old favorite that I had. A lot of you, if you saw my Dupe or Dud video that included the Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powder in Radiant, I think, and then the Hard Candy Baked Bronzer, I mentioned the Sigma F25 brush. I love the shape of this brush, but over the years, I think I've had this now for 3 or 4 years, as long as I've been blogging at least, as I've washed it, just kept it, even with putting brush guards on it, hasn't held its shape. It's been shedding like crazy, and I knew it wasn't long for my brush collection, so I was asking you guys for recommendation. But then recently, Sigma sent me one of their latest sets. I recently reviewed it on the blog, so I'll link to that below, but in it was an F25. There is a dramatic difference between these two brushes. In part, it is the fiber. I think this is a natural hair brush, so it absorbed any powders that I, or any liquids that I used on it. It was a little harder to clean. But this is part of their new Sigmatech line, which is, I guess, special fibers that are supposed to stay together for longer. It's not going to absorb the liquid products. I've been using it for about 3 weeks to a month at this point, and have washed it multiple times, and it's really held its shape without a brush guard or without any of those like brush shaper things. So I've been really impressed with this, and I really only kept this around so that I could show them to you and then chuck it, because they've really updated their brush fibers and the format such that I'm back to loving it again. And this I love for contour. It's great for just going into the powder, getting it on the tip of the brush, and then applying that directly into the hollows of your cheekbones. And then, because it is so tapered, it has a broad side, I go in and apply highlight. I actually applied all 3, bronzer, highlight, and blush with this today, because the shape just makes it so versatile for covering broad spaces as well as more narrow on your face. And last is a lip product. It's another repeat from last month, but I just knew that when I had seen the progress that I had made in this, because it's become my purse lip product, you know, that like default, it's universally good to wear with everything, whether it's a colorful eye, dramatic eye, nude eye, just mascara, this is what I've been going to, and I realize that I have done some solid work, so it would be an injustice not to include it in this month's favorites. Once again, it is Soap & Glory's Sexy Mother Pucker Gloss Stick 3D Volume Lip Shine. Yes, that I'm pronouncing that correctly. No, I'm not saying what you might think I'm saying. A few of you were like red alert when I said it in last month's favorites, but no, it is called Sexy Mother Pucker Lip Gloss. And this is in the shade Nudist. Highly recommend it. It's not so gray undertone that it's gonna unflatter those that are super warm. It's not so warm that it's gonna unflatter those cooler undertones. It is just a universally flattering nude, and it has enough opacity that it will cover up any unevenness in your lips. It has a thick consistency and obviously a nice sheen so that it looks like you're kind of wearing a kind of glossy, balmy lipstick hybrid or tribrid, I guess. But it doesn't unflatter any flakiness, because I gotta be honest, when I applied this today, my lips were kind of in rough shape, a little dehydrated, a little flaky, but once this goes on, it just does a really good job at smoothing your lip texture out and flattering them, and also hydrating and moisturizing. It has a really pleasant, like sweet, kind of cookie or candy scent. So I really enjoy that about it as well. And it's reasonably priced, so you can't beat it. It's an excellent purse lip color. That's kind of a good question. What is your go-to, like the lip product that you throw in your purse? I'd be really curious to know what everyone says about that, because I'm sure it's one of those universally flattering, like it goes with, you can kind of count on it going with any look you're wearing, no matter what. That's what this is for me. So let me know what yours is in the comments below. In the meantime, those are all of my favorites for the month of July. I really hope you guys enjoyed hearing about them. Please, once again, tell me your favorites below, including your purse lipstick, lip gloss, whatever your lip color is. I would love to know. Thank you once again for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.